So students, in this lecture, fourth of quantum mechanics, will study the behavior of atom as a magnetic dipole in external magnetic field. So here we have an atom where nucleus is present at the center of an atom, and electron, it is orbiting around the nucleus in this way. And suppose L vector is the orbital angular momentum of this orbital motion of electron. And because, what is the expression of L vector? It is R cross mv. And the resultant vector in the cross product, it is always perpendicular to the plane containing these two vectors. It means the direction of this orbital angular momentum, it will be that direction which is perpendicular to the r vector, to the plane containing r vector and velocity vector. So the direction of orbital angular momentum vector, it is perpendicular to the plane in which the electron is moving. So suppose this is the xy plane in which the electron is moving. Electron is moving in this plane. Suppose this is nucleus and this is electron and this is revolving around this here. Then the direction of L vector, this is electron which is revolving around this nucleus. So the direction of L vector will be this. So this L vector, it is perpendicular to the plane of paper. And electron is present in the plane of paper. So nucleus, if the nucleus, electron and atom, it is placed in XY plane, then the direction of orbital angular momentum L vector, it will be in the direction perpendicular to the plane in which the electron is revolving. So that is why this L, it is perpendicular to this plane. If this is XY plane, then this L, it will be in the Z direction. And this atom, it is placed inside the external magnetic field B, B vector. And now suppose that theta be the angle between this angular momentum vector, orbital angular momentum vector of electron, and the external magnetic field B. And we know that in the previous article we have studied that when the electron, it is revolving around the nucleus, it acts like a current carrying loop which produces magnetic field. And this current carrying loop, it behaves like a magnetic dipole. So this electron which is moving around the nucleus of an atom, it is equivalent to the magnetic dipole. So we know that this magnetic dipole, it will possess some magnetic dipole moment. So the orbital magnetic dipole moment is given by, we have already derived this expression in our last article, which is mu L vector, it is equal to, this is the orbital magnetic dipole moment of electron, it is negative of E by 2m into orbital angular momentum vector. So this we have already proved in our last article of atom as a magnetic dipole, where this negative sign represents that direction of this orbital magnetic dipole moment vector, it will be opposite to that of direction of L vector. So that is why in this figure I have shown, what I have shown is that direction of mu L vector, it is opposite to that of direction of L vector. Now under the effect of this magnetic field B, this electron, it will experience torque. means there will be interaction between the orbital angular momentum vector of electron and the magnetic field, because of which this electron, it will experience torque. So we can say that this magnetic dipole, under the effect of magnetic field B, external magnetic field B, this magnetic dipole, we have already studied this in our 10 plus 2, where the magnetic dipoles, they experience torque in the presence of external magnetic field B. So because this atom, it acts like a current carrying loop, and the deflection produced by this current carrying loop, it is same as that of the deflection produced by magnetic dipole in the magnetic needle. So that is why we can take this atom equivalent to the magnetic dipole. And when any magnetic dipole, it is placed under the external magnetic field B, it experiences torque. So there will be interaction between the orbital magnetic dipole moment mu L vector with external magnetic field B vector. So there will be the interaction of these two, which results in the torque. And this torque, it is represented by tau vector, and it is equal to the cross product of orbital magnetic dipole moment vector and the magnetic field vector. So it results from the interaction of these two. So from this equation two, what is clear? It is clear that we know that the resultant of the cross product of two vectors, it is always in a direction perpendicular to the plane containing these two vectors. It means the direction of this torque, it will be perpendicular to mu L vector and B vector. So this torque, it will act in a direction perpendicular to both of these. So that is why the direction which is perpendicular to this B as well as this mu L, it will be this, the plane in which the electron is moving. So the torque, it is acting in this direction. This direction. And from our equation number 1, what is equation number 1? Equation number 1 is mu L vector, it is equal to minus E by 2m into L vector. If this torque, it is perpendicular to mu L vector, then from equation 1, this torque, it will also be perpendicular to this angular momentum vector. So we have concluded that this torque, it will act in a direction perpendicular to the direction of orbital angular momentum vector. And also from one of the form of Newton's law, we know that the torque is the time rate of change of angular momentum. Torque tau vector, it is represented as dl by dt. And from this equation, this equation results in that this torque, it will produce change in L that is equal to dl vector. But the magnitude of L is constant. It means only the direction of L will change. So this torque, which is experienced by the magnetic dipole in the presence of external magnetic field, from this equation it is clear that this torque, it will produce a change in L. And L is a vector quantity which is having magnitude as well as direction. So L vector will change if any of the magnitude or the direction will change. But the magnitude of L remains constant. It means this torque, it will only change the direction of L. And change in the direction of L, it will take place in the direction in which the torque is acting. Suppose the torque is acting in this direction. So the direction of this L vector, it will change in this direction. I'll make you understand with one example. So now suppose that because of the torque, dl vector is the change in L vector which is produced by the torque tau. And one more thing which we have proved is that this tau, it is perpendicular to mu L. Initially in this article, we have concluded that this tau vector, it is perpendicular to mu L vector. Mu L vector is anti-parallel to L vector. Therefore, this tau vector, it is perpendicular to L vector. And this change dl vector, this change dl vector, it is the change because of this tau. It means the direction of this dl vector, it will be perpendicular to L. See, this tau vector, if tau is in this direction, then because of this tau, this change has produced. It means this dl vector, it will also be in this direction. But direction of this tau, it is perpendicular to this L vector. It means the direction of this dl vector, it is also perpendicular to L vector. So dl vector, it is also perpendicular to L vector. So how you can say that this is the change produced in this? Because this is perpendicular to this. So we will say that because this angular momentum vector, it is a vector quantity and this is perpendicular to this change. So what we can say is that its magnitude remains constant. The length of, you can magnitude from magnitude, you can say that the length of this vector remains constant. And but how it, its direction will change? Suppose this is the dl change. After the dl change, its direction will change. This will be the new L vector. So in this way, the torque tau, it produces the change in L by changing its direction. So angular momentum L vector, it remains constant in magnitude, but its direction changes. So in this way, what will happen? See, this torque, it is acting in this direction, from this to this. It means this L vector, it will experience torque in this direction. If this L vector, it is experiencing torque in this direction, so because of that torque, this dl is the change in L. So what will be the new direction of L? This will be the new direction of L. This will be the new L. Then again, because of the continuously acting torque, the direction of L, it will change from this point to this point. This is also the direction of L. Here the magnitude of L is not changing. The length of this vector is not changing. Only its direction is changing. And now, if the direction of L is changing, what does it mean? L is always perpendicular to the orbit of electron. So if the direction of L will change, it means the direction of this plane of orbit will also change. Here, if this is the direction of L and this is the plane of orbit of electron, if because of torque, the change in the direction of L is this, then the orbit of electron, the plane of orbit of electron, it will also change. It will move from this point to this point. Similarly, when the direction of L will change further, then the plane of orbit of electron, it will change itself such that it remains perpendicular to the direction of L. Similarly, suppose the direction of L is this. At any time, the direction of L is this. Then, what will be the plane of orbit of electron? It will be perpendicular. So, what I am saying is that this L, it will precess this cone, it will trace this cone around this magnetic field B because of that torque. Because of the torque acting at every point, torque is acting tangentially at every point. So because of this torque, this L vector, it will trace the tip of this L vector, it will trace cone. And as this L will precess around this magnetic field B, so as the direction of L will continuously change, so the direction of the plane of this orbit, it will also continuously change. Means it will also precess around B. How? As the direction of L will change, it will also continuously change in this way. In this way. So, this plane of orbit of electron, it will also precess around B with some frequency that is known as Larmor frequency. And this precession of L vector, precessional motion of this L vector around B, it is known as precession. And how it happens? This is the direction of B vector. This is L vector. And suppose theta is the angle between them. And this theta will remain constant. The angle between L and B, it will remain constant. Only because of the torque experienced by the L vector, it will precess in this way. It will precess in this way. So at the top, what we will have? A circle, and that is this circle. So this is B, this is L vector, and this L vector, it will experience torque, and because of torque, it will precess a cone around this magnetic field B, which is known as Larmor precession. And if L is precessing around B, so is the case of plane of orbit of electron. So it will also precess around B. So this I have already told you, that because of this torque tau, there will be change dl in the direction of the L vector. So because of that continuously experiencing torque, this L vector, it will trace a cone around B vector such that the angle between L vector and B vector, that is theta, it remains constant. And this is known as precessional motion of L around B. So as L is perpendicular to the orbit of electron, so this orbit of electron, it also precesses around B. Now, as this L vector, it is antiparallel to mu L vector. Means there is 180 degree angle between this L vector and mu L vector. So, mu L vector, it will also precess around B vector. As the direction of L vector will change, so the direction of mu L vector is exactly opposite to that of L vector. It means the direction of mu L vector will also change. So this mu L vector, it will also precess around this B and it will trace a cone on the opposite side of L. So there is a precessional motion of magnetic dipole moment of electron. There is a precessional motion of एंगुलर मोमेंटम वेक्टर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन एंड देयर इज द प्रीसेशनल मोशन ऑफ ऑर्बिट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन अराउंड एक्सटर्नल मैग्नेटिक फील्ड बी. सो नाउ वट वी विल कैलकुलेट, वी विल कैलकुलेट दैट वट इज द फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ दिस प्रीसेशनल मोशन. सो हाउ वी विल कैलकुलेट दैट? इफ डीएल इज द चेंज प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय टॉर्क टाउ, देन वट इज द चेंज इन द डायरेक्शन, चेंज इन द एंगल विद द चेंज इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ एल. एल वेक्टर, इट चेंजेस इट्स डायरेक्शन फ्रॉम दिस टू दिस. सो देर विल बी द चेंज इन एंगल हियर. And suppose this change in angle is d theta. And omega is the angular velocity of this precession. And we know that the angular velocity omega, we know that angular velocity omega, it is equal to d theta by dt. So what will be the change in angle? D theta, it is equal to omega dt. And one more thing. We know that this angle, it will be equal to arc upon radius. Angle is equal to arc upon radius. And what is the arc? Just consider this segment. Here, this is angle. This DL is acting as an arc. What is the radius? This is the radius. And it will be equal to, this angle is 90 degree. So here we have this. This is L vector. This we have to calculate. This is theta and this is 90 degree. This is the direction of B vector. This is the direction of B vector. So this is right angle triangle, where this one is hypotenuse, this one is base, and this one is perpendicular. The magnitude of hypotenuse is L. So what will be the value of perpendicular? Perpendicular upon hypotenuse, it is equal to sine theta. It means this perpendicular, it will be equal to L sine theta. So that is why I have written this as L sine theta here. So this angle d theta, it is equal to arc upon radius. So this angle d theta, it will be equal to arc is dl upon radius is L sine theta. So d theta, it is equal to dl upon L sine theta. So this implies d theta, that is angle, is equal to arc is dl upon radius is L sine theta. And what is the value of d theta? It is omega dt. So put this value here. You will get omega dt. It is equal to dl upon L sine theta. Now move this dt to this side. And you will get omega is equal to dl by dt into 1 upon L sine theta. And what is this dl by dt? It is equal to tau. So that is why I have put down this dl by dt is equal to tau. So we have this omega is equal to tau by L sine theta. Here we are calculating omega. After calculating omega, we know that Larmor frequency f, it will be equal to omega by 2 pi. So we will calculate Larmor frequency of the precessional motion of L around B, of mu L around B, and of plane of orbit around B. Now we have to find the magnitude of tau. Tau vector is mu L vector cross B vector. Taking magnitude, it will be mu L B sine theta. So what is the value of tau? It is mu L B sine theta. So put this value here and you will get omega is equal to mu L B sine theta upon L sine theta. So this sine theta will be cancelled out. So we have omega is equal to mu L by L into B. Now what is the value of this mu L by L? From equation 1, which is the equation in vector form. This was the equation number 1 in vector form. Take its magnitude. Move this L vector to this side and take its magnitude. You will get mu L by L is equal to E by 2m. So from equation 1, this mu L by L, it comes out to be E by 2m. And put this value here instead of mu L by L. So we have omega is equal to E by 2m into B. It means this Larmor frequency, it just depends upon the magnitude of external magnetic field. Angular velocity of the Larmor precession, it just depends upon the magnitude of external magnetic field. So what will be the frequency of the precession, which is known as Larmor frequency? It will be omega by 2 pi. So Eb by 2m by 2 pi, it is equal to Eb by 4 pi m. So it is concluded that the Larmor frequency of the precessional motion of L vector around B vector, or plane of orbit of electron around B vector, or mu L vector around B vector, it just depends upon the magnitude of the magnetic field, external magnetic field, because E is constant, charge on electron is constant, 4 pi is constant, and mass of electron is also constant. So Larmor frequency, it will vary by varying the magnitude of the external magnetic field. If you will increase the strength of the magnetic field, this Larmor frequency, it will also increase. And if you will decrease the strength of this magnetic field, then this Larmor frequency, it will also decrease.